Just had a chat with Mr. David Simon, who's the principal of Queen's Royal College. They're fighting, they're joining the fight to eliminate violence against women. Good morning to you, Mr. Simon.
Good morning. Good morning to you, your entire panel, and all of Trinidad and Tobago.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us. Tell us about She's Royal.
Okay, so She's Royal is a program that we have instituted in Queen's Royal College, which attempts to deal with the whole issue of the violence against women, the crimes, very heinous crimes committed against women in our society. That is where the impetus came from. We're really looking as an all male institution and gradually attempting to change the attitudes of males, especially as it applies to that relationship with women as it pertains to violence against them. So the school attempted to sensitize our male population, young male population, to some of these issues surrounding this very, very controversial but yet important topic.
And I think it is so important what is happening, Mr. Simon, because we see all the time where, you know, for us to get to a place where we understand certain things is that we need to start at an early age. And so even in high schools where we know that as teenagers, we can be so impressionable, I want to commend Queen's Royal College for taking this move.
Thank you very much. We appreciate that. It's something that we see as serious. Certainly, the college has always been an institution which has focused on all-round education, not just certification. Certification is one aspect of education. And we certainly see our responsibility of producing good citizens, not only of Trinidad and Tobago, but of the world, as a very important element of our educational existence.
Mr. Simon, how was the information that you guys have been sharing with the students? How have they been received? How was the reception so far?
Well, remarkable. When we started it, I don't think that we expected it to explode as it did. Because what we did is we had assistance from the court arm of UWE and IGDS from UWE. So we worked hand in hand with UWE, and we had two segments with our students. We started off with the upper school, our fourth, fifth, and sixth formers, and then we did one for the first, second, and third form. The arms of UWE came in and they worked and they did what is known as a rape red card culture discussion. Yeah. So they held a discussion with our young men where they presented different scenarios, and it's almost using the same concept of a football game. So the young men had green, red cards and they would respond. And around the responses of the young men, you had educated discussions about particular concepts and violence against women and that sort of thing. And it was very interesting to hear the views of the young men. Now, the idea of doing something like this is that we can be sensitized to how they think. So it is going to provide us with the data in terms of who we expose them to, what we expose them to, in order to consolidate or change certain mindsets.
And again, congrats to Queen's Royal College. So will this be an ongoing thing that QRC will be doing?
Yes, it is. It is being interwoven into our curriculum, both the open and the hidden curriculum. In fact, what we have is all now we are really planning to ensure that it becomes deeply entrenched in the school. So what we have right now, we have an essay and an art competition running. Each level of the school has a different topic, a rubric for them to do their essays, etc., right up to sixth form, where we have a logo competition. So we want to come up with our own logo. We are looking at getting a theme song, and for the next term, we are looking at competitions in the spoken word and calypso and that sort of thing. So we are intertwining it into the daily lives of the students of the school, because we want it in the open curriculum as well as the hidden curriculum. So yes, it is something that is deeply entrenched. We're working on that. And 15, 20 years from now, this program should still be here, modified, of course, by the leaders of that particular time.
All right, Mr. Simon, I want to thank you so much for sharing with us and continue the work that you're doing with the young men at Queen's Royal College. And I'm sure that it will make a difference and an impact in their lives.
Well, we hope so. And it's not only the men of the young men of Queen's Royal College. Really, we're hoping that the impact is going to be one that is going to begin right here in QRC, spread to, of course, Trinidad, the wider society, getting males to understand the need to change that viewpoint of violence against women. And today is a very important day. It begins 10 days of advocacy, working against the International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women and Children.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Simon.